Hi, and welcome on Chef's Review Live, a program where we discuss current problems of modern hospitality, especially food trucks. My name is Michał Orłowski. Let's have a look. So first, let me remind you, this is a live show, so please ask away anything you like, any questions, drop them in on our live chat. The more questions, the better we will cover the subject. And today's subject is mass events, how to use them to make as much money as possible. My guest today is Carlo Assuni.
Welcome.
How are you doing? Everyone. And let's get started. So first of all, mass events. They're more and more common these days. You do have concerts, food truck festivals dedicated for the food trucks, of course. And they're gathering more and more crowds, right? So there are events for even 30, 40, 50,000 people, even more, hundreds, right?
Yes, yes.
So how do we approach that subject? How do we, you know, increase the performance of our food trucks? Where do we start?
Increase. We start from the beginning. We need to be prepared, to be ready. Because as you said before, we are gonna get lots of customers. That's our wish. So we need to be prepared to serve more and more customers in the same time. So we need a lot of equipment, but not a lot in sense of a lot in numbers, but lots in sense that the bigger the better. Because for example, fryer
efficiency, right?
Yes.
Invest in some better.
Better equipment and proper equipment. For example, if we're talking in a food truck which is selling, for example, burgers, we buy in a big grill. So I mean, maybe 1 meter.
Or even more, if you can fit it.
If you have in the room for that, of course, that's what I'm saying. Bigger the better. Why is that? Because we can serve, we can do more customers at the same time. Remember that, like
the more
you said,
customers, the more money.
Yes,
right?
Yes. And the customers, if they see that we are very fast, they're gonna keep coming because they see that we can serve a lot of them.
Yeah. So it's good to have a queue, but the queue must disappear pretty quickly. So you have to have efficient equipment. What about the you know, the position of the equipment? That's important too, right? To streamline it.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's one of the basic key, the base of our business. Because just a reminder, in the food truck we have in not so much room to move and to have people which are working. So everyone needs, in my opinion, not to move, so just to be static, and but in that you just need to have all he needs in that small amount of space. So that means you should have like in the big fabric. So that means montage. You starting from one thing. So for example, let's say burgers. So you need the grill. You need just beside the fryer, and then you need the preparation table. And beside that, the end is the cashier. That's in the way I see it. For example, just to
it's pretty much the way I was taught. It's what you were saying. The chef, the one who cooks, shouldn't move an inch. Like the less movements he makes, the better and faster and more efficient he is, and the more he can serve. And that's really crucial. We cannot stress enough how important that is. Of course. The location is also very important, isn't it?
It's one of the most important, is the key. It's the other key which allows us to have lots of customers and happy customers, which I think is the goal. Because if you have in happy customers, so they're going to keep coming and everyone is going to talk about us. To reach that, the location, of course, is the first site, which is important, because when he's gonna get the first sight of the customer, of the guest, so he's gonna get the chance to have him as a guest.
To get the sales going, right?
Yeah, well, as
so
a guest.
It's important to be where the traffic is, where the crowds are.
Yeah.
Totally. There's also ways, like, you know, of course, these events tend to be really crowded, right? So you have thousands of people storming one way or the other. It's also important to be visible, right?
It's like we said before, is important at the site, that the guest is gonna look at you and he's gonna feel safe, he's gonna see that the queue is gonna be served very quick, and then a product which that is in the second importance, because first the client doesn't know if we don't have a brand, doesn't know if we are good or not, he's gonna see through the queue. If our queue is gonna be a little bit, and then he's gonna see that they're gonna keep coming, so he's gonna come to us. Then if he's gonna walk through the food region or the food zone, like are in the festivals, so just we're trying to be on the center, on the focus of visibility. So there where he's gonna look, so we are there.
Different colors also, yeah, just
as well, that helps a lot. And that helps a lot if we serve in the same stuff of the other food trucks. Because we need to be different. Because of course we need to take the attention of the client, of the guest.
So I've noticed quite a lot these days. It's not only about the visibility of the food truck or the place, the venue, but it's also about the visibility of the product, right? So it's like a walking commercial, like a walking advertisement, where people have something in their hand that has the wow factor. It draws attention. People are asking, hey, what's this? Or where do I get this? Like, you know, glowing sticks or a intricate garnish on top of your burger even. So all these things, right? Like, you know, making, especially at nighttime, when it gets dark, and these festivals tend to be, you know, late in the afternoon into the evening, where you have something glowing on your burger, that draws attention, right?
Yes,
that's
absolutely
a good thing to do.
Yes, yes. Just doing things which other are not doing.
Exactly.
If you're doing the same burgers, so like I said, like we said, just try to use your mind and try to put something new on that.
On an old dish, true. All right, I see questions are flowing in, so let's switch into question answer mode. All right, Murray's asking, what's streamlining the equipment mean? That's what we are talking about, right?
Yes, like I said, we should not use so much room, not to move, because in the food truck, as we all know, is a very, very short amount of room, a short amount of space. So we shouldn't move. We need to have everything in place, and everything needs to have a meaning. So that means, like I said before, we have in our grill, which we are doing our burgers. For example, we're doing burgers. Let's make an example. So we need here or there, for example, our grill. Then beside we have in our fryer, and then we have in our table which are we making our burgers and we serving them, and then we have in our till, our cash, where the people are gonna cash in. So every space, every little corner have his own utility, and we are not gonna just move without no sense.
Yeah, the way I see it is basically, you know, streamlining, like in a industry, right? Like in a factory. Yeah. So bit by bit by bit by bit. And the best way to do it is you take your product, like for example, a burger. You see all these ingredients that you have on your burger, and you pretty much constitute your kitchen the way you constitute your burger. So you need buns, you need grilled cheese, you need burger, you need sauce and whatever.
The fryer.
And that's pretty much determines the continuity. So you start with the grill.
And the fridge, which
of course,
for that reason, you're starting from the fridge, which
exactly
should be on the back, then the grill and the fryer, which they should be just one beside the other one. Like this, like you said before, it's just like building a machine or building whatever. And everything is gonna have a sense, a logic sense. Yeah,
pretty much what is to be avoided is running around.
Yeah.
In any restaurant, any kitchen,
of course,
or in the world,
we cannot
food
have,
truck
for example, the grill there and the fryer, here at the till. It doesn't make any
exactly
sense.
Exactly, so people don't bounce off each other. All right, John, what's the best product for mass events in your opinion?
Best products, that it depends on what we want to sell, that is important. It's important to have not decide what's the best product, but decide what you want to do and what you are good to do. So that means if you know how to do, for example, the best burger, and you just know that you're doing the best burger, so you're doing the burger. And that's for you is the best thing. Just not to try something new, which you don't know. Okay?
Just you because it might sell or might not.
Yeah,
right.
But if you know that you're good in that, so just do that. You can choose, of course, to do something different. And that it depends. It depends in which festival you go in, what, for example, music you go in, or what kind of festival is, because not always are music festivals. As well, there are some other kinds of festivals. So, more than the products, I will focus on myself, what I can do, and what I have on my hands. So that means what kind of food truck I have. Okay.
What I would also suggest to answer this question is to pick a product that is easy to do. I've seen it a couple of times.
Very fast.
You know, I love these festivals. I tend to see like at least five or six during the season, which may not be a lot, but obviously I don't have too much spare time on my hands. But I'm trying to use the rest, you know, visiting food truck festivals and others. And I've seen it many, many times. People want to do a very complicated dish in a food truck setup.
It shouldn't be.
Suddenly it turns out they're hitting like, you know, the 100th customer mark or even more. They have a queue for a mile and they can't handle it because, you know, it's too complicated. It takes too long to cook. And there's nothing worse to see your customers walking out of the line and going to your competition. So the product, to answer your question, John, needs to be quite easy, right?
Yeah, quite easy.
It needs to be attractive, but it needs to be easy to make.
Easy to stock as well.
Easy to stock.
And that we coming back, we're returning on what I was saying, that we need to use our space, the space we have. So to use in the maximum way we can possibly imagine.
Lucy, how can I find out where the crowds will be before the event?
Well, we are not a magician. No one is a magician. We just try to get their attention and hoping they are going to watch to us. They're going to look at us. That's what we can do, because no one will say that they're going to be 100,000 in that point at that time.
Nobody can tell.
Nobody
can tell.
But we can help that, like I said before, just trying to capture their attention with some colors, with, for example, we're selling something others they're not doing, or with the music as well, or with some lights. There are some kind of stuff we can do to get their attention.
And of course, because we cannot foresee where the crowds will be, but what we can do is to avoid bad locations. And some things we already know not going to work. Like we already said, the toilet area, a food truck shouldn't be
close to that. There's a drama.
It sometimes happens. People just take the last spot and, you know, they try to make business with it, but that never works.
I wouldn't, because that is not making business, it's just making troubles.
It's making
troubles because you're buying food which you are not going to sell because you are in very bad location.
Exactly.
So it's no sense for me, it's no logic to open just to be open and waiting or just wishing to have in customers.
Exactly.
For the customers, you have to know how, or just use your brain.
Besides, we already spoke about that. Of course, you can contact the organizer. You can get a map of the whole event. So you kind of can place yourself somehow where the traffic will be. But if you avoid all those bad locations,
the very
first place near the entrance, it's not the great place. It's not to be great when you're standing next to a big brand or, you know, some big company that's already huge in marketing. Because obviously they're going to take your customers. It's not great when you have three burger or four burger joints next to each other. So these are the things that you can talk
near
the stage where there's music going on and people are dancing. So if you avoid all these and you speak to the organizer, you can actually pick a spot. And to be honest, you probably know it too from a restaurant business. Being on a food truck festival is like reading a menu from the customer perspective. What I've noticed and what I'm doing when I enter a food festival, food truck festival, I always make a round or two just to see what's on the menu. And I do not just pick the first booth I've seen. I always go around and then I make a choice. And that's like reading the menu. People always go up to the last page. Yes. And they come back to pick an entree. So that's pretty much the case here, right?
Yes. Just like one big flow of people which are
exactly
going around to watch. And there is just a connecting of what we were saying before, that we need some colors or something which others don't have or be in a good spot.
Yeah, but so with a good spot, I mean, like, you know, we're talking about events, mass events with thousands of people. I mean, sometimes a more quiet spot, trust me, I'm talking from a cook's perspective, right? Because usually it's us who have to dish out all the dishes, right?
Yeah.
A somewhat cooler spot is much better because you can focus on quality, you can focus on standards. It's not always great to be in the very middle of the tornado.
Where the war is.
Yeah, exactly. I've seen places that actually lost customers because they were so popular. They were the victims of their own success.
Well, yes, but like we said before, you need to be prepared.
Exactly.
So, I mean, if you know that you go in a festival, which there are going to be 10,000 people, so you know that at least 1,000, you need to calculate at least 1,000. So you need to stock up your fridge, to have workers which they know what to do, they know how to do in a very quick and fast way. And you need as well not to have only that 1,000 portions, but as well to have a van just beside you and having
just
the next 1,000, 2,000 portions. Because like this you know that you're selling everything. You need to be prepared.
True that. I see that was our last questions, so I want to thank our viewers for all those questions. I thank you, Carlo, for being
thank
here.
You.
Thanks a lot for the chat. If you have any more questions or you want to share some thoughts with us, please write us an email on the address below. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.